Thursdays on USA.
We're back on NXT with NXT TakeOver Stand and Deliver hanging in the balance. 2 weeks from tonight, we're going to our general manager, Warrior Regal.
Gentlemen, thank you for joining me here tonight. Now, it's obvious that the situation between the two of you has got out of control, has reached boiling point. In fact, I've got the bloody police involved. And I will not have you embarrass this company that so many people have worked so hard to create. What I have here is a solution to this situation. This is a contract for Kyle O'Reilly to face Adam Cole in the co-main event of the second night of NXT TakeOver Stand and Deliver. Now, Kyle, you're still not medically cleared. This match can only take place when you have both signed this contract and you acknowledge that NXT is not accountable for anything that happens to both of you.
Regal, I want to tell you a little story. I want you to imagine that you were born blind, that you could not see, and then one day you wake up and you can see everything. You know what we call that, Regal? We call that a revelation. And I had one. I realized that I didn't need the Undisputed Era anymore. As a matter of fact, the Undisputed Era was holding me back. And you know who made me realize that, Regal? It was you, Kyle. I mean, for God's sakes, I bought into this BS that maybe the Undisputed Era was about brotherhood. Maybe that's what it was all about. It was never about that, Kyle. I sat back and I watched you challenge for the NXT Championship not once, but twice. Then I watched you fail, not once, but twice. And what do? You try to befriend Finn Balor? You try to have Finn Balor join the Undisputed Era? Have you lost your mind? And then it all made sense to me. It all made sense because deep down in your core, you are nothing more than a lapdog. You were a sidekick. You were someone comfortable being on the sidelines. And that is not me. That is not Adam Cole. I am the greatest NXT champion there has ever been. And I will never sit on the sidelines because I am nothing like you. You lost sight. You lost sight of what this was. You lost sight of what the Undisputed Era was. It was never about friendship. It was never about a brotherhood. It was about being the best. And damn it, you were looking at the best. Honestly, Kyle, all we've been through, you should be thanking me. Because when you look yourself in the mirror, do you actually think you would have made it to WWE, let alone been successful, if it wasn't for me? Do you think the Undisputed Era works without Adam Cole? I'm the one who led the charge. I'm the one who main evented. I'm the one with the legendary title run. I'm the one who sold the t-shirts. Undisputed Era without Adam Cole is nothing. And you, Kyle O'Reilly, are nothing. I cannot wait to fight you at TakeOver Stand and Deliver. And you want to know why? It's because I already know who wins. The entire world already knows who wins. The only one that doesn't is the pathetic lapdog sitting across this table. know each other for a long time. At least I thought we did. When we first got here, we didn't care who we stepped over to succeed. Four hungry pit bulls determined to take a spot at the top of the card where we belonged. You could say we were shocking the system, but we were making a statement, and we didn't give a damn about whose expense or who was footing the bill. You do realize we will forever have heat with the general manager, not to mention an entire locker room full of guys. I grew up, man. I started to take some accountability for my actions. And look a man in the eyes before you kick his teeth in. No more sneak attacks, no more four-on-one beatdowns, no more BS. And since coming here, to this place, we've become better wrestlers. We became better fighters. We became champions. We became stars. But only one of us became a better person, a better human being. Adam Cole is just the same asshole that walked into this place 3.5 years ago. And I keep forcing myself to really, truly believe that the last 3.5 years meant nothing. That the Undisputed Era meant nothing. I'm forcing myself to really, truly believe this. Because if any part of me thinks for a second that one day you and I could be cool again, maybe one day you and I could go for a beer, I won't do what is necessary to put you down for good. I sold my soul for the Undisputed Era, and I want it back. You are an insecure prick that used his best friends, and that is so, so cold, and somehow I'm not surprised in the least, but let me tell you something, Cole. Not one single person is gonna be surprised. Look him in the eyes! Not one single person will be surprised after I beat you into a pulp. And for the first time in damn near 4 years, I sleep like a baby.
Attaboy, Kyle. Go ahead, sign that death warrant.